So good to see you. Last time we were here, you all helped us set a Guinness Book of World Records, and we will never forget that. We have some special memories here. You guys have been with us since day one, and we will never forget it. Thank you. So needless to say, I don't have to ask if you're ready. But listen, let me explain something to you about tonight's show. Tonight, I want you to come with me on this journey through the human experience I write through song. Alright? We're gonna go through experiences as a literal physical being and a spiritual being. So are you ready to come with us? Alright, seekers. We're gonna find some tonight. I know you're ready, come on. Yeah.
Now, I told you we were gonna take a journey tonight. So stay with me. This next song is about the innocence of a child, the innocence of youth, the heart of a child, the heart of a dreamer. And I want to remind you, no matter how broken we get, no matter how bad life breaks us down, no matter what betrayals, heartbreak, or loss comes, don't ever let them rob us of that childlike heart, that childlike spirit. Continue to love. Continue to trust and believe. Continue to dream, my friends. Don't ever let it die. Never die.
After the song was written, I've learned a lot about what to do when I find myself in a prison, my friends. A lot of these are prisons of our own making. Bad decisions and choices we make can create situations that are difficult, but other times it's just life. We deal with loss, we deal with death, we deal with struggle, adversity, rejection, betrayal. And we can get locked up in these struggles in life in our mind, and we can freeze. And in those critical moments, it can either make us or break us. It's all in how we progress through that prison and in that struggle. Do we find purpose in our pain? Do we learn to dance in the rain? I know for me, I held on to hope, and the only hope I had at certain times was a right. I'm gonna fight my way through this because I know when I get to the other side of this struggle, of this prison, I'm gonna be able to help someone else out who's going through the same thing once I figure this out. Just enough to keep me pressing on, to keep me fighting. You were meant to thrive, my friends. You were meant to thrive, even through adversity. It's all in how we frame it. Sometimes we have to get crushed so we're on our back and remember where we're supposed to look for help and for answers. Sometimes the breaking is necessary. Sometimes the prison is necessary. It's all about acceptance and how you want to view your circumstance. So come with me on this journey, my friends. Come with me on this next road. Let's go down the prison. We'll be right back.
chapter called Struggle. Let's stay in it for a minute. I want you to chew on something real quick. And think about this. You know, as human beings, we have inherent instincts that are just reactions that happen when certain circumstances happen. They're just instinctual, they're impulsive. They just come. You know, we have a will to survive. If something's threatening, we recoil, we know what to do. We fight, we recoil, we know what to do. I've had an observation I want to share with you, and I think it pertains to this next song, because this next song, like the last one, when we found ourselves in these prisons, when we found ourselves weathered and rusted, barely holding together. I found that just like an emergency, when something happens, you'll hear someone say, oh my God, call 911. Oh my God, do this. Oh my God, we gotta get into the hospital. Oh my God, we gotta do this. Oh, what are we saying? We're saying, oh my God, we're calling out to our Father. It's instinctual, it's inside of us. We just do it because it's in our DNA, my friend. We can't run from it. We can't run from it. It will find you until you are broken enough to open your eyes. You will get broken and keep getting broken until you say, oh my God. Let's do it again, my friends. The song's called Weather.
Houston, Texas, how you feeling tonight? I can't hear you. How you feeling, Houston? Come on. Yeah. Oh, yeah. You're going to feel a whole lot better if you're walking home with this guitar tonight, right? Yeah. If you want this guitar, you got to be crazy. You got to make more noise than the person next to you, behind you, or beside you. You got to wear this guitar.
You heard the man. I don't know how you can take it up a notch further, but if you've got it, you better do it right here if you want that guitar. Here we go. Thank you.
people in here, but it looks like 20,000. I don't know how many it is, but I wish I had 20,000 guitars to give out tonight. Thank you so much, Houston. We love you. You know what, when we give these guitars away, we want this to not only be something you can take home and be proud of, but I want this to change lives, right? So when we give a guitar to somebody who's going to play it for the rest of their lives to be the next generation of rock and roll, we're going to do that. I see this kid right here. You see that red mohawk right there? Get up here, buddy. This little guy's been rocking the whole show, and he's going to be on this stage before you know it, all right? Give it up. What is up, buddy? What's your name?
My name's Zachary.
Zachary. Everybody give it up for Zachary. Come on. Hey, this guy's got it. I can see it already.
That's cool.
Hey, Dad, make sure he plays. Mom, make sure he plays. It'll be worth it, all right? Hey, in 5 years, we'll have him up on stage at the next show, all right? I need you to come back in, zone back in real quick, lock in with me. Lock in with me. You know, we're gonna turn to the next chapter of this. And we wanna take pictures with words and music. I want you to see. I want you to see these songs in your mind and feel them in your heart. I want you to come on this little trip. About life, and I'm going to say this a couple ways, about life after original sin, about life in the absence of all that's divine, life in the absence of God, life absence of spirit. Repeat after me. Say,
So Houston, I know what you're looking for. I know what we're all looking for. I want you to stay with me because we're getting ready to find him. We're going to find the faceless man right now, right here in Houston, Texas.
Choose to live for always, so to come inside.
live in a world that's so divided, my friends, so polarized, so separated. And it's my opinion that that's exactly what the powers that be, that's what they want. They want us divided. They want us separate. They want us compartmentalized in our own little niches, in our own little groups, thinking we're right, they're wrong, and bickering. You know why? To keep us distracted from holding them accountable. They start dividing us and programming us in kindergarten, my friends. They teach us about how to be good slaves to authority, about how to do this and do that and think this way and think that way, all conforming us into this divided group of assets and pawns.
Yeah.
You know, years ago, it was very, very taboo to talk about suicide, to talk about addiction, to talk about mental health issues. But in 1994 or 95, Mark had a friend who was on his way to college that killed himself, committed suicide, had a full ride to a Division I university on an athletic scholarship. Had everything going for him, good family. But for some reason, he decided he wanted to give up on life. And this guy didn't give up on anything. There are people hurting in this world, and it's more so today than I've ever seen in my lifetime. Kids are so confused at such an early age on what their identity is supposed to be and what they're supposed to become. We're inundating with this indoctrination that's just wrecking people's minds, it's wrecking people's souls, it's separating them from the existence they were supposed to have as human beings. We have 22 or more veterans a day that are killing themselves. How many veterans we have out here? Thank you for your service, but we're losing good men and good women when they get home too. I have faith in humanity, and I have faith in Texas. Oh, I have faith in Texas. And I know that there are people out there right now that may be looking like they're having a great time on the outside, but they gotta go home and they suffer in silence. Their life is falling apart, and they consider sometimes, you know what, exit may be an option. If you're having those thoughts or thinking that, I know right here in Houston that if you talk to someone in front of you, behind you, or on each side of you, and you say, man, I'm having those thoughts, there is a brother and a sister in here right now that will wrap their arms around you and walk you through tomorrow, the next day, to get you the help that you need. I tell you what, don't be afraid to ask for help. And hey, people who aren't suffering, we have instincts, we have intuition. Start reaching out to people. Break down the walls. You know, you see someone hurting, go talk to them. We see it every day. But that's what this song was all about. That's what it was inspired by. It's called What's This Life For?
feel you. I can feel you. I've been feeling you all night. It's in waves. Are you feeling us out there? Are you feeling us? You know, this next song, we've heard so many stories about how this song has been a bridge between a father and a son, and a mother and a daughter, and a mother and a son, and a father and a daughter, and a grandparent and a grandchild, bringing the hearts of parents to their children and children to their parents. Thank you, God, for that. It's about the concept of breaking generational curses and realizing that we don't want to pass down certain things to the next generation. It stops with me. It stops here. Now, we don't win every battle, but we're going to win the war, right? Because you always get back up and try harder the next day. You always do. So don't hurt yourself or kick yourself when you fail. It's just a setback, like a slingshot, to spring you forward, my friend, all right? So everybody, turn on your cell phone. Turn on the lights on your cell phone, please, and lift them up in the air. Come on, I want to see 20,000 cell phone lights. Let's leave the light on for the next generation to show them a better way. With arms wide open.
I'm trying to reach you. I am.
I just got goosebumps. I can feel it. You're lighting me up. You're lighting me up. Come on, you're not done singing. Come on. We're not done yet.